Just a heads up, full Ghostbusters Afterlife spoilers ahead. If you've not seen the movie, turn this off now. If you don't care, well, let's start it off. Today on Toy Shiz, the family that... But I'm not going to finish that sentence. Welcome back, everyone. Toy Shiz here, and I am back yet again to give you guys another fresh look. And today, we are totally checking out the brand new Ghostbusters Afterlife Target exclusive. The aptly named The Family That Busts Together. Thank you, Leo. Let's just say this. As a Ghostbusters fan, I totally get what you're saying. Busted makes me feel good. We're not going there in terms of, the underlying meaning. But because of internet and people's mentality these days, that's exactly where we're going to go with this. So not the most appropriate of titles. We're just going to say, how about the Spangler Family Values? There you go. Hire me, right? But yes, we have Phoebe Spangler and Egon Spangler straight from the Afterlife movie. Really nice box art on the side. Interesting art, I will tell you that. And on the back of the box, the really nice, the real sweet ending to this movie. With, of course, Egon Spangler and his grandchildren. And one of the worst write-up bios I've ever seen. Like, you might as well just left it blank. Here's the barcode. If you want to go ahead and find these at Target, that's where I found mine. You might have to ask him for the back to grab one, but they should have been out November 28th. Here's my thoughts on Ghostbusters Afterlife. I loved it. It was fantastic. Don't ask me to talk about anything else because I will pick this movie apart. And I'm really trying to start going into movies and being a little bit more open-minded and going, oh yeah, that was cool. I liked a whole heck of a lot more than I disliked, of course. But that being said, the movie has its issues. We're just going to be clear about that. If they never make another Ghostbusters movie, I will be happy. Now, let's retread to real Ghostbusters, and I'll be even happier. But I think you guys will be happy with this box set. For all you Ghostbuster fans out there, sit back, relax, grab yourself a nice hot cup of ectoplasm. This is a look at the brand new Hasbro's Target exclusive Ghostbusters Afterlife, the Spangler Family Values box set. Well, I mean, Spangler Family Values, I mean, he did leave his family for... You know what? Here's the two figures all out of the packaging with all the different accessories. And quite some very cool accessories, I will tell you that. In totality, this is a really nice set. It does come with an alternate Terror Dog Build-A-Figure head, so this would be Zool. It's well articulated. I really wish now that I would have gotten an extra set of the Ghostbusters and... so I could build the other one. I don't have the Tully's Night Out set. And she does look good with these Terror Dog Sentinel figure, which was not in the movie. I don't know. It also comes with a spores, molds, and fungus jar. Also kind of the slime from Ghostbusters 2. The hole on the bottom is odd. That was something where I was like, okay. I thought maybe you could open this up. That would have been kind of cool. Maybe put some slime, like actual slime in there, but no such luck. It also comes with a... oh, God. It comes with the smallest piece ever. This is the chess piece that, of course, Egon plays chess with Phoebe during the movie. Then you've got a PKE meter with nodules at the top going up as opposed to the prior release where they're out. So it's nice to have one that's red, one that's green, and they're roughly the same size. You get a Neutrona Blast, an updated one for the new pack, which I think is the best part about this set. It's very cool. It looks like the Spangler pack, the one that Phoebe and Egon work on in the film. It's a little bit different than the prior packs. It still works the exact same way. This will unclip. You slip it over the figure, and it does look nice. The Neutrona one and the attachment cord is a little bit different. It's a little bit more flexible than we've gotten before, which is nice. Kind of got warped in the packaging, you can heat it up, but it has nice little paint apps here and there that kind of bring it to life a bit better. And of course you can detach the cord still if you'd like, but it just works a little bit better and has a little bit more detail and texture. This will pop off just like in the movie when they're trying to replace the collider, whatever you want to call it. I really appreciate that. That's something, you know what I mean? That's something to, in a really nice nod to the film, and it just simply attaches back. And then you have Phoebe. Phoebe came out really nice. It's a really nice rendition of the actress Spangler on her jumpsuit. Now, she does have all the articulation you'd expect. You can put the PKE meter right there on her belt loop, so I'm glad that they included that. The only problem I would say is in her feet. They don't move, or at least mine do not move. They don't budge. They don't work at all. So you kind of have to fidget with her legs to get her in a good stance. That's the one thing. I do wish she had a little bit more articulation in the feet just to kind of make it more naturalistic. Other than that, double jointed elbows, the pack goes on her. It's a nice looking figure. And overall, I'm happy with the figure, especially when you affix the proton pack to her and it fits on her really nice. I mean, the exception of a child lugging around the giant pack, suspension of disbelief right there, right? The Ghostbusters could barely do it. But it works. Egon himself, with whatever happens in the movie and the ending, and it's with everything that's happened with Ghostbusters, I don't have a problem with it. It's very sad. It's very melancholy. I'm a sucker for that type of thing. It did get the old nostalgia going and everything else. I don't exactly agree with it. I don't know if it's exactly what I wanted to see. I don't know if it's exactly what I wanted to see in an action figure. I did buy it, so that tells you something. But overall, it's nicely done. I like the clear plastic. He does look like the really great CGI in the film, so I'll give it to him all day. It's sad, and it's odd to have the figure itself, but they do look good together, and yes, you can recreate that scene, which again, the ending, yes, it's got its flaws here and there, but it was overall nice. I did enjoy that, and that was kind of a final nod to the team, because yeah, it's not going to be happening again ever, right? But you can actually recreate a lot of what happens just with the figures that they've released so far. So in that sense, it's pretty cool. You can deal with Lucky turning into the Terror Dog. Zool, of course, you got the original Busters doing their thing, going after Gozer. So I'll tell you what right now, I would love to see a new Gozer figure, right? Because the chick from the OC plays her, which was really cool. I liked seeing that. I mean, you could even make an Ivo Shandor figure, but I would love to see a Gozer split apart with the whole ectoplasm veiny kind of thing going on, and then get some of the Neutrona wands like in a like a circle or a belt so that she's trying to like wiggle them off. You know what I mean? That would be a cool accessory for a new Gozer figure. You have podcasts dealing with all the I knew I wasn't gonna like those mini puffs. I still don't like them. I think it's so ridiculous, but you know, these days you gotta have a cute little sidekick, baby Groot, baby Yoda. Oh god, don't even get me started. And while it doesn't fit, I mean, often photos, maybe in the background somewhere, you can get the Plasma Series Ecto-1, but no, it's not going to fit these figures. And then, of course, you have Phoebe and her grandfather, Egon, which, again, it all looks great. It all looks good, especially that one scene, you know, Winston kind of notices them and all the Ghostbusters start turning around and seeing Egon. Again, it's nice in that sense. But yeah, this is it, right? This is what you're going to get for Ghostbusters these days. You always have Ghostbusters the video game. That's the true Ghostbusters 3. I agree with that. You've got Ray Stantz, who, I mean, in the movie, there was an awkward phone call between him and Phoebe. It works, I guess, at the end. You got Venkman, who shows up, and the mini scene with Sigourney Weaver at the end was okay. And you got Winston, the sex appeal and the money now behind the Ghostbusters, basically. I do like what they did with Winston and Janine in that final scene. And it leaves it open-ended. And to be honest, yeah, I don't know if I really want another Ghostbusters movie in this sort of universe fashion in that sense. Maybe do a cartoon. That would be cool. Maybe, again, go back to the real Ghostbusters, something to that degree. But I like the head sculpt on Egon. I think it came out great. And just again, having all the Ghostbusters back on your shelf, older, wiser, things change. You know what I mean? But it's still nice to see. But the kids were actually great in the movie. I did enjoy them. I thought all the actors were fantastic as these new Ghostbusters, which is such a breath of fresh air from these jerks right here. Never have these kids return. I'm going to tell you that right now. But you got Phoebe, and you got Trevor together, and all the kids scale nicely. Podcast, Lucky, and I do really enjoy the kids in this movie. I thought it was a really nice little nod, sort of a fourth wall breaking. Ghostbusters was this really raunchy comedy, if you look at it, the very first movie, and then the cartoon took off, and they became a family-friendly sort of movie, even though it's totally not family friendly, but that's where I think the family values comes into it. The idea that it's become something else over the years, and it's just become something better, something that the entire family can enjoy. And I think that's where they really landed and nailed it with the whole Spangler thing. Even though he turns into a deadbeat dad and runs out on his family, he could have showed Ray Stantz the whole thing with the pit and all those screaming ghosts and everything else. But I'll leave it to that, right? We don't need to talk about any of that, but to see old Egon, new Egon, the packs do fit. The new pack will fit on the ghost of Egon. It doesn't fit perfectly. It's a little bit of a different mold. Something's different between the figures. It's not much, and you can see how they kind of differentiate. This is the new Afterlife pack as opposed to the original Ghostbusters pack. The original Ghostbusters pack, again, it can fit on Egon, but it doesn't exactly fit perfectly. You're going to kind of have some dislodging here and there. You can make it work for what it is. But that's going to wrap it up for my look at the brand new Hasbro's Ghostbusters Plasma Series 2-pack, Target exclusive, the family that busts together, Ghost of Egon and Phoebe. Two great figures. Very happy with this set. Great accessories, great looks for the figures. I like what they did. It's probably the best in terms of Hasbro taking over the Ghostbusters line so far. I'd like to see more of this. I'd like to see more figures. Sky's the limit. But I am curious to know what you guys think about this new Ghostbusters Afterlife set. Is it for you? Will you be grabbing? Comment below, let me know. Let's talk everything Ghostbusters Afterlife. And I'm going to leave you guys with that. As always, drink some great coffee, eat some great food. But most importantly, remember, busting does make me feel good. I'm talking about going out of it for ghosts. Man, come on, get your mind out of the gutter. And when you do, let me know what you found. I'll talk to you guys soon. Adios.